Does it happen outside in? Does it like, would the bugs that get on her first be the ones that are attracted to fresh skin? And then once that's all gone, then it goes into the musculature and the, I don't know, all of the organs and stuff like that down to the bone? Or how would you expect the decomposition to work like that?
Pretty much, it's going to be all parts at the same time. Actually, I have, maybe we can go in. I have a few images of experiments that were done. I'm going to pull up, let's see, share my screen here. I'm just going to go full screen with this PowerPoint. So the body's going to go through different stages of decay, and each one of those is going to be inundated with all sorts of different insects. There's going to be insects that crawl up from below that are underneath the organism, and there's going to be insects that are digging through the insides of it that are working on the skin, and they're going to come at different stages as well. So as you look at the different stages of decomposition of an organism, we'll just say an organism for this. There's a lot of experiments have gone on. In fact, I'm going to go back just a little bit here. Let's see. So, as you look at different insects, are going to want to hit at different times. Like the necrophage is the first species that feed on the corpse. A lot of flies and a lot of beetles just going after the flesh of the thing. They're going to get in the omnivores. There's going to be other organisms that just anything, they'll eat anything. So they don't care. Wasps, ants, beetles, they're not necessarily laying eggs in the organism to have their larvae feed on it like a fly, like a lot of these different flies will do, but they will attack it. And they'll actually be eating the flies that are, they'll be kind of just going after anything that's there. But they might actually, as you can see, it might actually slow the rate of decomposition because they may be attacking the things that are going after them. Other parasites and predators, other beetles and other true flies will show up there. And then incidentals, all sorts of different organisms are going to be coming after that body as it's there. Here's kind of a breakdown. And obviously, we can't read this, but people have spent a lot of time trying to work through what organism is going to show up when. So you can see at the top, there's the three different stages, the putrefaction, the black putrefaction, the buteric fermentation, then dry decay. And then the organisms that are going to show up at different points in time. The ones at the top are the ones of the succession organisms. They're the ones that matter, the ones that you care about, because they're going to really help you time out how long a body may have been there. So with Gabby, they found the body at a certain point of time. She hadn't been seen for a long time. So there was a pretty good guess. It was less guesswork as how long she'd been there, but it was surely still informative as to how long her body had probably been at that exact spot. There's a lot of things you can learn from this. You can learn in some cases if a body was moved from one place to another. You can learn how long it was exposed to the outside, whether or not it was maybe wrapped up in something for a period of time, because sometimes decay will take place before any insects can get onto it. If it was enclosed in a bag or something along those lines and then brought to a certain location, if it was, the two locations were drastically different, then maybe insects would have infested the body early on. And then if a body was moved to a totally different location with a different flora of insects in that area, then you'd be like, well, why are the remnants of these insects there versus the other ones that you're seeing that are actually native to the area in Wyoming, something
Now,
like that.
is that true even when, like, say, for example, I'm not saying that this is the case, but if Brian Laundrie killed Gabby Petito like 50 miles away outside of where she was found, or even closer than that, 10 or 20 miles away, and then he dumped her where they found her, is there a big enough difference even between just a matter of tens of miles 20, 50 miles, something like that, the different kind of insects?
Probably not. In a place like Wyoming, probably not, right? A lot of desert and mountain, and that's about all you get in Wyoming. It would have to be two very different ecosystems.
Okay.
And especially somewhere out like out here, you can go from your house to my house 100 miles away, and it's all deciduous northeast forest, a lot of the really same organisms. But in a place like Wyoming, if she was killed at a lower elevation and brought to a high elevation or vice versa, you can get different insects and things that way. But it would have to sit for a while and then be moved for things to really get into it. So you're probably not going to learn that information. Then again, I am not a forensic entomologist. They can do some pretty amazing stuff these days. So there's a lot that can be learned. From
gotcha.
It. So
okay.
Let's really quick. I was going to show you those insect or those images of the pig. So we have a few different stages of decay. We got the fresh decay first, you know, after it's first killed, then bloat, then decay, post decay, and dry skeletal. And you can see here. So in this case, they brought out a pig, had it completely wrapped up, a little dead baby pig, for the experiment's sake. And they're, in this case, they're going to be recording the temperature through the time that it's there, all the organisms that come to it, how the body itself is decomposing. So we're not going to go through all the nitty gritty details of that. You can learn a lot from an experiment like this. Way back when, the first person that kind of pioneered this, it was a guy, he had 150 human corpses out of what they called the body farm. He was
I have read about that. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, out in Tennessee. And he would try in all sorts of different temperatures, times of year, times of day, trying to figure out what was going on. But anyway, let's just go through this little one. So obviously shortly after death and that fresh, you get into the bloating stage. And you can see here around the face, especially places it's easy to get into the organism. Again, not to be too graphic, but entry points. A lot of things can't break the skin as easily. So if there's an entry point like mouth, eye sockets, ears, things like that, that they can really get in, especially with something like a pig, really tough hide, that's where you'll really start to see it kind of work through. And things are really taken to ripping apart the skin in that stage. Going to the next, now we're in kind of the decay stage. And you can see fluids are coming out of the organism. It's broken out. Leaking, unpleasant odors. The gases have kind of left as well because they've all been able to escape. And insects at this point are really taking to the body and just really taking it apart quite heavily at this point. And then our post-decay stage, I imagine this would be multiple weeks given the environment in Wyoming during the summer. I was probably somewhere around this stage. Things have been eaten away quite a bit, and not a lot would be left at that point. But again, I don't know exactly, you know, if it's really cold at night, that's going to slow it down quite a bit. I don't know exactly what was going on at that point in time with the body.
Now it says hide beetles are dominant in dry environments, which the Grand Teton area, that is still considered high desert, is it not?
Oh yeah, very, and especially this year, extremely dry. So you're gonna have a lot of hide beetles, carrion beetles, and things that can chew through the toughest parts of it at this point in time in the decay process. All the flies, they've done everything they can. There's not a lot for maggots at this point to really do on the body. It's gonna be mostly just the hide beetles and other things that can chew up really tough. Ants probably could still do some damage here.